Welcome to Al Islah National Academy, the best foundation for great future.
Today, we are going to start a new chapter from the geography section of class 6. The chapter name is, or the topic name is, the Earth in our solar system. So in this chapter, we will learn about how the universe formed, about stars and constellations, about the sun and solar system, the last point, that is about the moon, meteors and the comets. So this topic is a very interesting topic, about the moons. So while we are the childhood age, our moms and dads or grandparents, basically the grandparents are listening about the story about the Chand Mama, that is moon. So in this chapter, we'll learn about this thing, this whole topic we'll cover. So let's start from the very beginning, how the universe was formed. So now universe was formed, it means it's formed near about 15 billion years ago. How it's formed? So while in our universe, some matters or molecules are there, it's just flying one place to another place. And at that time, one cosmic egg. So why the author used the cosmic egg? Because it the egg, it means it does not have an egg. It's the shape of like a similar egg of the hen's egg and bird's egg. It means it's a stone, cosmic stone. Why people are using this one, a cosmic egg? Because the stone has a shape, is accurate shape of the egg. That's why the people are using this one, a cosmic egg. So other name of the, or other name of this cosmic egg is a Big Bang. So now, due to this explosion, now explosion word means the conflict between two stones is known as explosion. While explosion occurs, so fire comes out, or the thing are naturally it's become too tiny, it means too small. Tiny means small pieces. So while explosion is occurred at that time, fires comes out, it means burning gases comes out, as well as the thing, whatever this one, collapsing together. So both the things are separate or aggregations, like a small piece or tiny pieces. So while this explosion occurred among the stone, it means cosmic egg, so some materials comes out or matter comes out and it just flying together. So now, while molecules formed, the molecules came together and formed giant clouds. It means all the things were just flying over this one due to gravitational force, this one flying over here and there. So after that, they again summation or the aggregation, it means combined together or joined together. So it's create a cloud. So now after cloud formation, what happened? Due to the gravitational force, already in the this one history chapter I discussed about the gravity. So now shortcut definition of the gravitational force is that a special force, that is gravitational force is a special force which attracts towards the earth or towards the flat surface. So this type of force is known as gravitational force. If you know wants to more about the gravitational force, so you read the science and science more and more, then you will get the gravitational force. So now the collidation of this one matters as well as the molecules. So cloud formation was happened at that time. What happened? This stable in the this one northern sorry this stable in the space with the help of gravity. So after that, what happened? All the things combined together and makes the universe like nice universe. So after that, millions of millions years later, it's what happened. The stars found. How stars found? The stars found, it means while explosion was occurred, at that time small pieces of stone just flying together. So due to this reason, already I told you, explosion occurred at that time, fires comes out. It means the small piece of stone, it's turns into the fire. So while this was flying in the sky, at that time, this piece of stone we are considering as a star. So now the thing is that while we considering the stars, at that time, stars gives us the heat and energy. How? Why it gives an heat and energy? Because due to explosion, fires comes out, or the piece of stone is become the heat and energy, and it gives the light. That's why the stars also gives us light and energy. So now, how can I prove that this one stars gives an energy? So for giving the proof, I may consider this one, sun. So while we are using sun, or the sun is the closest stars from the earth. This is the closest, it means nearest star from the earth. So sun is not the thing. Sun gives, or sun is the natural source of light, but sun is a star, one star from the solar system or the Milky Way galaxy. So later on we'll discuss about the Milky Way galaxy, but the sun is also a star. So nearest star or the closest star is our sun. So sun produces light and heat and energy. So similar way also other stars, whatever the other stars are there in the sky or in the galaxy, so all the stars gives us the light and heat and energy. So now, already I just uttered a word, that is Milky Way galaxy. Now, how Milky Way galaxy formed? So now galaxy was formed, the millions of millions stars combined together, and it gives a new space. So such type of the combinations or aggregation or summation of the stars gives us a galaxy, and such type of galaxy is known as Milky Way galaxy. So our native galaxy is Milky Way galaxy. So we are living in the Milky Way galaxy, and other names of Milky Way galaxy is Akashganga. Akashganga in the mythological or in the religious spiritual subject is considered as Akashganga, but in the English language or in the geography we may consider this one Milky Way galaxy, and we are living in the Milky Way galaxy. This is the Milky Way galaxy is becomes the universe. So this is the story about the universe. Now the next topic is stars and constellations. So now what is the stars? Already I just discussed about the stars. It means the small pieces of stone while explosion was occurred at that time. Some stone pieces or tiny pieces just flying here and there. Such type of or such pieces of this one stone is known as stars. So now constellation. Constellation means the summation or addition or combination of more than two or three stars combined together and gives a structure is known as constellation. While seven stars combined together, it means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. If I consider the seven stars together, then it gives a shape or structure. So such type of structure is known as Ursa Major. If we look in the northern sky, you just look that side. Yes, northern sky. No need. I am just joking. This one, northern sky means if you look at the Goduli time, it means at exactly 6 p.m. or 5 p.m. if the sky is very neat and clean, at that time you look in the northern sky or you observe the northern sky, then you will get the Ursa Major, and big star you may find. Such star or this star is known as pole star. It means in the book has written Dhruva Tara, or in English this one is pole star. So pole star can be seen in the northern sky. So you just look in the evening time, you go outside and you just look in the northern sky, then you will get this one Ursa Major or the combinations of seven stars they are together. So the combination of seven stars, if some ritual stories are there, you may listen this one also. So now the combination of stars is known as constellation. Though regarding stars and constellation, you may get this one. So now solar system. So this the whole things are known as solar system. How? In our solar system, there are 9 planets was there, but nowadays only 8 planets are considered the last planet, or the number 9th planet is the Pluto. The Pluto planets are known as the dwarfed planet. It means it just diverted from its track. So Pluto diverted its track, that's why we are considering as a dwarf planet. But beside Pluto, there are 8 planets are exist. There is Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Earth, Venus, Mars and Mercury. All the chronological order, whatever I have uttered, it means this is the descending order. Now descending order means decreasing order. So first, this one is Jupiter. It means the biggest planet or the number one, the in size, the number one or the biggest planet is our Jupiter. It's followed by Saturn and then Uranus, and little bit smaller than Uranus is Neptune, and then Earth, and it's followed by Venus and Mars, and the last, it means the smallest planet of our solar system is Mercury. So now, all the planets are in the spherical shape. You may see this one spherical shape, this one also spherical shape, all the spherical shape. So, all the different planets have different features. Like for example, we may consider the Mars. You may heard the story about the Mars. Mars, everyone can know this one, Mongolian. So now the thing is that Mars is in red color, so it means reddish color. And now Earth is in green color. So every planets have their different types of function, different types of this one features. So now Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars are known as the inner planet. These four planets are called inner planets. Because why it's called inner planet? Because it's the inner sides of asteroid belt. So now in your book the asteroid belt is not there. So asteroid belt is not there, but in our solar system, if you go higher classes, then you will get, read about this one solar system, then you will get the asteroid belt. Among these 9 planets in the middle, after four planet you will get, and then asteroid belt. This asteroid belt, with the help of stone, this was created. So now, inner side of this asteroid belt, these four planets are there. It means this one, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. So this called are the inner planet. And beside these four planets, the other remaining four planets are known as the outer planet. So all the planets have their own axis, and they rotate in their own axis or own orbit. Such type of rotating or revolving are known as revolution or rotating. From next episode, we'll get this one, rotation and the revolution. Up to this much for this episode. Thank you so much.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon for latest update.